Friday, and we want to look at Psalm 106 together. And as we look at Psalm 106, we need to be reminded of yesterday's message, and that was how that the nation of Israel had gone down into captivity and were extolling the faithfulness and believing that God was going to deliver them. This one is kind of tied to that one. It's also Babylonian captivity, but it tells the reasons why God has taken them down into captivity. And it just goes through and enumerates the number of times that Israel had rebelled against God. And he talks about they rebelled down in Egypt, and they didn't serve the Lord down in Egypt, but turned to false gods down there. Then they rebelled in the wilderness and would not go into the promised land when God had delivered them and showed his mighty hand and works. Then it talks about once God got them into the promised land, then they rebelled against God and would not keep his laws or statutes. Therefore, God had to drive them out of the land. Again, we can see so many parallels with our nation as well. Well, this is another psalm. You're going to have to read most of it for yourself, but let me just give you a few verses here. But look at Psalm 106. Praise the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Who can utter the mighty acts of the Lord? Who can declare all his praise? Blessed are those who keep justice, and he who does righteousness at all times. Remember me, O Lord, with the favor you have toward your people. O visit me with your salvation, that I may see the benefit of your chosen ones, that I may rejoice in the gladness of your nation, that I may glory with your inheritance. Now, what the psalmist is doing is thanking God for how God has taken care of his people and how wonderful God is to his people. But then he's also going to talk about how his people have not been wonderful as their responsibilities towards God. In verse 6, he says, we have sinned with our fathers. We have committed iniquity. We have done wickedly. Our fathers in Egypt did not understand your wonders. They did not remember the multitude of your mercies, but rebelled by the sea, that is the Red Sea. Nevertheless, you saved them for your name's sake, that he might make his mighty power known. And then he talks about how he delivers them there. And then he says in verse 12 that they believed his words. They sang these songs of praise for God's deliverance at the Red Sea and how God overthrew the Egyptian and punished the Egyptians. But then look at verse 13. They soon forgot his works. They did not wait for his counsel, but lusted exceedingly in the wilderness and tested God in the desert. And he gave them their request, and he sent leanness in their souls. Then he talks about their rebellion in the wilderness. Even though God had done 10 plagues, God had delivered them through the Red Sea, God had done miracles and wonders, they still rebelled. Talks about the golden calf and how they did so many wicked, wicked things during that time. Then it talks about even in that late, after those 40 years, as they're getting ready to go in the promised land, their rebellion, and you'll have to read through that, but in verse 30, it talks about Phinehas and how he stayed a disease and a destruction by God upon the people through his acts. Then it says in verse 31, and that was accounted to him, that is Phinehas, for righteousness to all generations forevermore. Then he talks about in verse 34, they did not destroy the people once they got into the land, concerning whom the Lord had commanded them that they were to go in and drive out the people, or those that won't drive out, then you destroy them. He says, but in verse 35, they mingled with the Gentiles. They learned their works. Now notice this, how quickly they go off into spiritual adultery, and also the results of that. And they served their idols, which became a snare to them. Now notice verse 37 and 38. And when you talk about this, you got to remember, we have done far worse. We call it abortion today. Back then they called it human sacrifice, child sacrifice. They even sacrificed their sons and their daughters to demons and shed innocent blood, the blood of their sons and daughters. Then he talks about the wrath of God in verse 40, came upon them, was kindled against his people, and how he had then to punish them because of their wickedness. Now, if God will do that to Israel, his covenant people, even though he made a covenant with Abraham, but God would drive them out of the land, God would bring punishment upon them for their wickedness, what is God going to do to America? I mean, it's obvious that America has turned its back upon God. It is obvious that we slaughter our children. 4,000 a day, if I remember right, is how many kids throughout the United States die through abortion. It's amazing how much we parallel this. The idols of our day and time are not idols you set up as a pole or as a statue and you worship it. Our idols are things like football or sports or some kind of a recreation or people. Musicians are called idols. We've got a show called American Idols. And then notice the psalmist then in verse 47 calls for God to save them. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the Gentiles to give thanks to your holy name, to triumph in your praise. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel from everlasting to everlasting. And let all the people say, Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, let's do that now. Let's praise the Lord. Father, we praise you. We thank you for how you have blessed America, how you have taken care of us, and you have provided us in such a magnificent way that we have more than most every other country in the world. We've been protected through wars, and we're grateful for that. We're thankful for all that you've done for us. And Father, we recognize our nation has turned its back upon you. Forgive us for that. Give us time that we as your followers might be able to draw this nation back. Use us that we might see revival in the land. And we do certainly praise you and we give thanks to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.